Here are all the tools I use for this job. I used a precision screwdriver with a standard head that's a 1/8 inch flat or standard head on that driver. A number two Phillips, a black marker, a measuring tape, and optionally I'm using a cordless drill with a number two driver, Phillips driver, screwdriver head on it because it makes it easier and quicker. But if you don't have a cordless drill, the standard screwdriver, sorry, the Phillips screwdriver number two will do just fine. And other than that, I also have a level, which is also nice to have, but not needed to have. You can either eyeball it or measure from the baseboard or floor up to where you're going to put the screws in or the plates in to hold the towel bar to see if you got it level. Here's a 24-inch towel bar, and you know, the procedure is the same as for an 18 or a different size towel bar. The hardware is more or less the same, but basically I got it inside the bag that it was shipped in. I'm going to take it out of the bag to make sure that I have all the parts, and so that you can compare your parts and make sure that you have all the parts. So let's unbag it. Oh, by the way, it is an item number 3324DB, and it is from Better Home Products, the Waterfront 6 collection. So let's get that out. All right, so first thing is the towel bar itself. Pretty basic stuff. It's got two ends. And let's take a look at the ends here, because those are kind of important. So let me just take a quick look at them and show you what is significant here. Okay, each one will have the end piece such as this. And it has a little lock nut or a little lock bolt here. That's what you're using the 1/8 inch flat screwdriver to actually lock it down to the wall plate with. Make sure you have one of those. These are really tiny. If it's out of the bag or rolling around, I would strongly suggest that you put it back into this piece of hardware so you don't lose it. So they're very small and they're very easy to lose. Let me check the other one too to make sure it's in there. And yes, it is. And that's basically it right there. It looks like a little. All right, that's it. So make sure they both have that. If they don't, look in your packaging for that, those little pieces, because you can't lock it down without it. The bar, pretty standard, right? Oil rub bronze coating on it, looks nice. And the mounting hardware. This is crucial stuff to look at. All right, we've got two of them. They should have two screws, two wall anchors, and two plates. And basically, that's all the hardware you should have right there. So if you have all that stuff, next we'll go to the bathroom and install it. Now, I currently already have a bar installed on my bathroom, which may make the job easier, or it may actually make the job harder. But either way, this stuff installs the same way. I will be using all the hardware here to install this bar in the wall, and we'll go from there. Okay, here we have my old chrome towel bar, and again, it's a 24-inch towel bar. It comes off the same way as in the reverse manner that the new one's going to go on. If you don't have this bar, if you're just installing it fresh, I'll probably post a link here on this video somewhere to give you the fast forward to where I put the anchors, new anchors in for the new towel bar. But if you have one already, I'll show you how to take that off next. We're looking at the bottom side of the towel rack mount right here, and let me zoom in there for a bit so you can see the little screw here right here that's holding that in. So I'm just going to use my 1/8 inch precision screwdriver to turn that counterclockwise. Hopefully I'm not too much in the shot there. Yeah, I am. Bear with me. Okay, there we go. I have it in there. And we just turn it counterclockwise, like so. And that should be enough there. So let me back that up a bit. So now just hold on to the bar and slip the bar out of that. Lift the actual mount off, and the other side of the bar just comes right off. So just put those two pieces aside, and there's the mounting bracket. Now, I'm not showing you the other side because the other side is exactly the same way it comes apart the exact same way. Take the securing screw out from underneath it and then pull it off. Now yours may be different, maybe the screw will be on top, not sure, but just look around, you'll find it, and remove it, and then remove the actual handle of it right here, what's left of that. And now you see the actual bracket that I have in here. Now I was thinking maybe I could get away with using the old bracket, but no, I cannot. This is not the same shape as the current bracket I have. It's not the same size either. So I'm gonna need to put the new bracket in there. So the next thing we're gonna do here is remove that bracket. And all I gotta do is unscrew it. Now if you're using your Phillips screwdriver, just use your Phillips screwdriver to unscrew it. Like just count, there's two screws there in the center. As you can see, just remove them with your screwdriver. I'm gonna use my cordless. That's where this comes in real handy. One, and you might want to keep that hardware around. Somebody else might want it, sell it at a garage sale, whatever. Okay, so there's the hardware off the wall, the old hardware. And you'll see I have two anchors in here already. And you can say, hey, I can use those anchors. Well, in our case, I can't, because those are horizontally spaced. They're put together horizontally, and our bracket mounts up and down. Okay, so now what I mean by up and down is that this bracket has a bevel or a flanged edge on it, and this is where the top hook of the bracket's going to hold on to, and the bottom hook is going to locking screw is going to go on the bottom. I'll get you a better angle on this now. Okay, here's a more clear representation of why the old bracket wouldn't work. Well, there's the differences between the two of them. You see that the holes, the mounting holes on the old bracket are horizontal right here, and the mounting bracket, the new mounting bracket has vertical alignment. And these little flanges on this bracket need to be on the top and bottom, because that's how the actual arm that holds the bar actually works. Now, where I come in into some luck here is that, number one, that bar was already very level. So basically, because I have this already on the wall, it's already measured out, and somebody's already put a little mark there in the center of it. And I can use that for my next bracket. And, prior to doing this, if you didn't have these anchors or this on here, you need to measure out the distance between the two arms on your new towel bar, and then figure it out on here. All right, here we have the towel bar itself, and if you look at it, you see that it's actually exactly 24 inches in length. And well, you may think, hey, well, I'll just measure 24 inches out on the wall and I'll be fine. More than likely that's true. I'll show you something that's built into the bar though, so that you can understand that there is some flexibility in length, just a little bit, not a lot. And we'll go from there. Okay, here's my problem. I've got these two mounting plate holes here from the old plates, and I need to cover those up with the new plates also. But also, I got to make sure that the bar is not going to be too far in length for these two things. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it up on these two little blocks, little patches. And as you can see, I'm overlapping here. I got white on the end. So I'm going to stretch that out a little bit on both sides just to cover it up. And there we go. And then I'm going to see if the bar, once that's there, if the bar is going to stay inside inside the irons while that's happening. And I got a little bit of play, but it still works. It doesn't go anywhere. So now I'm going to mark those spots. So a little hard to do. I'm holding that bar, so I'm going to take my little pencil here, and I'm marking it. I got the screw here, the mounting screw hole, so I'm going to mark that there. And then I'm going to put the other side up. Make sure I'm on that. And I am right there. And there we go, I got the other side covered up. Bit of a trick. Again, I'm going to mark where the hole, the mounting hole or the screw goes. And with my pencil, just put a little mark there. And pencil is easy to get off, just wipes off anyways, soap and water. And okay, so there I have my centering mark. So, you know, I guess my alternative would be take those anchors out, you know, unscrew them out and paint this, you know, cover up the hole, spackle it up, whatever, and then paint it and then do it again. But that would actually weaken this drywall. And I can actually mount two more anchors in between those two and have this work, I believe. So, you know, that's where I'm going next. So now we know the centers are right here where my marks are. So I'm going to now measure down, straight down, and then go across where I want it to cover. So I'll get a straight edge and do that, and so you can see what I'm doing with that. Okay, I'm using my level as my straight edge. I have a level mark, and it is level there. So I have my mark up here, and I'm gonna draw the mark down here, basically up, you know, vertically. There it is. And I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side here. And I know I'm in the way. There's no way for me not to be in the way. Okay, so basically I'm just drawing another mark in line with that one, making sure my level is level. There we go. All right, so now I have two horizontal marks, one on that one and one on this one. Next, we're gonna make the basic vertical mark here, and where I want to go is pretty well there in the center. And as you can see at this point, we're a little close to this anchor and a little close to this anchor, but I think we'll be all right. I'll use my plate here in a minute. So at this point, I'm going to use my level again as the straight edge and marking tool. So let's go up. I want to more or less be in the center of those old anchors, and it looks like I'm level there. Okay, so now I got an X marks the spot kind of deal going on here. I got one right here, I got one right here. Now, the next thing you need to do is put the plates there and see if you can actually have enough space for your anchors. Now, the plates again go up and down with the flanged edges. If you look, see that they're raised edges here and here on these. Those raised edges go to the top and to the bottom. So up to you how you put them on, but what I'm going to do is you put that center circle at the mark, your center mark, or the X where you mark the X, and here you could use your Sharpie. Actually, it's probably better to use a Sharpie here because you don't need to erase those marks. Okay, here's a closer look at what I'm doing with these plates. Again, the plates go vertical like this, so the holes go up and down so that the locking edges are, you know, on the top and bottom of the plate. And I'm going to mount that, you know, basically put that at the center mark. I'm going to mark the center. I'm going to mark the center of the top here. Get my Sharpie to work. There we go. And the center of the bottom. And what I'm looking for here, you'll see in a sec, is do I have enough space there to mount an anchor without hitting the other older anchors? So let's take a look. Here's my anchor. All right, there's my anchor. And I'm gonna put it at the center of that. And yep, I got enough space on that one. And yes, I have enough space on the top. Also, I can't get a really good angle on it, but basically it does fit. So next I'm gonna do the other side to make sure that I'm clear on that. So it's the same procedure again. Okay, you see here on the other side, the left side, that the actual crosshair is a little real close to that first anchor, the right-hand side anchor. But, you know, May not be a real big issue here. Let's see what we can do. All right, get our little Sharpie. I got that right in the center hole, right in the center. So I'm just gonna put a mark there. And I'm gonna put a mark on the top. Again, the alignment is vertically with the flanges on the top and the bottom. So, there we go. More or less perfect. Now we'll see if those anchors will fit. And those look really close. It actually will fit there, and it will actually fit here too as well. So I get away with leaving these anchors there because it'll be covered up by the arms of the new towel rack, and these anchors actually fit in those spaces where I have it marked. Now the other thing, you know, I really don't have to check because I know it's level already because I use my level to check them. The other way to measure whether it's level or not, if you don't have a 24-inch or a 48-inch level like I have, or any level at all, is you take the center mark and measure from that down to the top of your baseboard or to the top or to the floor, if you wish, and take that measurement, go to the other actual center spot, and make sure that the distance between the height from the floorboard, from the baseboard or from the floor on this measurement or this center point is the same on the other side. Then you'll get it more or less level. Well, you'll get it as level as your baseboard or your floor is. I prefer to use a level. My level says it's good. So next I'm gonna punch these holes here in to put the anchors in. And now the way I'm gonna do that is by using my number two Phillips. Now I know it's not a recommended use for the screwdriver, but it works great for this purpose. So I just put it right there, right on the hole, right centered. And then I'm just gonna lightly wrap on the back of the screwdriver and just like this. And, you know, hopefully there isn't a stud behind it. In fact, I know there isn't a stud because these would not have gone in otherwise. If you're putting this in without, you know, you didn't have an old towel, bar in, then make sure that you don't put it into a place where there's a stud behind it, because then these anchors will not go into the wood. They're meant to go straight into only drywall. And if you've got a stud behind where you're going to put it in, and make sure that there's a stud on the other side, and then you can just use a screw straight into the stud, I guess, like a drywall screw or something like that. So here we go again. I'm just punching a little hole, and the reason I'm doing that is to actually make sure that the anchors go in correctly. And if you see my anchor, you'll see that they're self-tapping, but you know they'll have a tendency to skate when you're trying to tap into the wall, especially these kinds. So I just punched a little hole, and there we go, and it's good enough to hold that right in its place. So when I use the cordless drill here to put it in, you can use, if you don't have a cordless, just use your screwdriver to get to work that in. And it won't go anywhere. It's going to stay right centered where I want it. So we'll do that next here. Okay, so I'm trying to keep that as straight as forward as possible, as straight in as possible, and hold it in. And now I'm just going to go slow here. Torque is a little off. Still off. I still need more torque. Okay, so there's my first anchor. As you can see, it's not even touching the other one, though it is close. These are still here. I didn't compromise the strength of this drywall, so we're good there. I'm gonna give that a little turn with my screwdriver just to make sure I got it in nice and tight. Yeah, that's good. Next, I'm gonna put the second anchor in. Same procedure exactly. Okay, so let's put it into the hole we punched in. Try and keep it nice and straight. Okay, here we are all the way in. go. They're both nice and tight. So next, we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Okay, here's the other side. We're going to use the same procedure. Get the screwdriver, put it right in the center. Punch it in a little bit. Make a little hole. Doesn't have to be super big. Just like that. Yeah, a little bigger. I like it big enough that it's going to hold just the anchor just like that. So there's one. That one moved a little bit when I hit it. And two. So with the anchor in there, yep, plenty big. So next, rinse and repeat. We do the same thing again. Screw those anchors in. Nice and slow all the way in. And it's flush with the wall pretty well. I'll give it a little twist with my screwdriver just to make sure. There we go. Test the torque on that with my screwdriver. Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good. Next, we put the plates on. So I'm just going to show you this plate. The other one goes in the exact same way, so there's really no point showing you twice. Okay, so we get the plate and basically choose the way you want it to go. You can go either way. As long as it's, you know, the alignment's vertical, and the flanges are on top and bottom, are here and here. Okay, so we'll do that. Just hand tighten the screws in so that they stay there. And again, like I said, if you're only using the screwdriver, then it's good. But I mean, I'm just hand tightening the screws in there. And then we're going to use our handy dandy cordless. I'm not going in all the way in, I'm just going to go in loosely. All right, because I want to align this as much as can with the centered mark that we first put in. So I think we're pretty well there on that center mark. So I'm going to use my screwdriver to tighten up the rest of it so it doesn't skate around too much with me. On me, I mean, that is. So there we go. And there we go. So next, we got to put the arm on that holds the bar on that plate. That looks pretty good. Just like that. I want to make sure I'm centered up enough that I can cover up the paint there. And if not, I got some spare paint. I can always put that over that. But if you don't, there we go. Oops. That's the wrong side. Upside down. Yeah, here's the other thing too. Make sure when you're putting these on that the screw is on the bottom, and this is facing in the direction that you want the bar to go. So first you hang it on the top, drag it down, and that screw is stopping me from going all the way down here. So I'm going to back up the screw on this right here. I'm just backing it up, then putting it back on the top and seeing if it goes on the bottom. I don't think I'm quite there yet. Give me a second. There we go. I just backed it up a little more. Yeah, and that's a good fit. Now I'm flush to the wall all the way around. So next, I'm just going to tighten up the screw on from the bottom using my little standard 1/8. Nice and snug. And maybe back that up so you can see. There we go. So I'm just turning that screw clockwise. And that's very, very tight there, and it looks good. It's not going anywhere. Got a good solid fit on the on this side. Next, what we're going to do is put the bar in here and then mount the other. Actually, next thing we're going to do, I'm going to mount that mounting plate on the other side, and then we're going to put the arm in the bar and finish this job. Okay, I want to show you something on the left-hand side bracket or mounting bracket here. I've got it in loosely, but I can't center it up on that hole. It's kind of up and to the right here, and no matter what I do, I'm limited by the travel in that bracket. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the bracket upside down, and that should give me more latitude to get closer to the center. Okay, so, you know, like I said, if you can't get it on center one way, flip it over and see if you can get on center that way. Okay, so I flipped it over, and now I got no problem getting on center. I'm just going to screw that down tightly with my screwdriver while it's on center and be done with that. And then I'm going to show you how to complete this job by putting the bar and the last arm in. All right, so we have the one arm installed and hanging there, no problem. Next, we put the bar into it. Pretty straightforward. Take the other arm, insert it at the other end of the bar. Then hook it onto the wall, make sure it's nice and snug to the wall. Test and see if the bar is going to go anywhere, and it's not. If there's a bit of play with it, but that's okay. That's you know, standard for these towel bars. And next, after that, we just lock down the arm, the last arm here, with our little 1/8 screw inch screw driver, and voila, nice and snug. Test it out, it's not going anywhere, and we're ready for a towel. Put your towel on it and be done. That's it for my video. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video and it helped you out in some way, do me a favor, click on the like button right down here. And, you know, if you wish to subscribe to my channel, just click on this link up here. And that should subscribe you to the Richard Lloyd channel or Richard Lloyd USA channel. Okay, again, thank you very much for your time and watching.